I've made a copy of ODB41, and I'm calling this one ODB42 SubQuery. When we were creating the foreign key for our employee's phone number table, I mentioned that I would show you a query to find all the foreign keys that did not have a matching primary key. We're going to do that right now. Let's take a moment to review what we had and what I've done to recreate it. I'm going into Tools, Relationships, and opening up the Relationship window. We have our employee's original table that we left out there, and I also added this employee phone number table when I made the changes for video 41. I also added some extra phone number records. So if we try and make the employee ID on the phone number table a foreign key of the employee ID on the employees table, we will get an error. This error is telling us integrity constraint violation, no parent key. In other words, that message is telling us that we've got some employee IDs on the phone number table that don't have a primary key. These are the records that we want to identify so we can either update them and correct them or delete them off the table. I've created a picture here to help us visualize what we're trying to do. We've got the two tables, our employees table and our employee phone number table. On the left, we've got the employees that do not have a phone number. In the center, the employees that have an employee ID that matches the employee ID on the employee phone number table. And on the right, we've got the employee IDs that do not have a matching employee ID on the employee table. These are the records that we want to identify in the results set so we can decide whether they need to be updated or deleted. I have a query here to do what we're looking for, and we're going to select all the employee IDs on the employee phone number table. That's this circle here. Then we're going to say where the employee ID is not in. Then we've got another select, and that is to select the employee ID from the employees table, which is this circle here. So this is our subquery within the query. And we'll notice that if we did take out this not, this center part here would be the same as we had in our inner join, because we would be selecting all the employees on the phone number table that are in the employee IDs on the employee table. So that would be just this center section here. As for which way is better, there are tools out there that will examine your queries and help you find the most efficient query, but that's beyond the scope of this tutorial series. I'm going to select this query, go into Queries, create a query in SQL view, paste this, and we're going to run it. We see that we've got a couple of zeros and a couple of ones. Let's add on a distinct. And rerun this. Now we're down to 5 records. These are the employee IDs that are on the employee phone number table that do not have an employee ID on the employee table. We will say that we looked at all these employee IDs and they all need to be deleted off the table. I have a query for that. This query here should do the trick. We're going to delete from table employee phone number where employee ID is in, and then we have the subquery that we just ran here. We're going to select all the employee IDs that are on the employee phone number table that are not in a select from the employee IDs from the employee table. So we've got a query with a subquery that has a subquery, showing us that we're not limited to a single subquery. And also, one of our subqueries is on the same table as our query. So you can do a subquery on the same table. Let's select all this, copy, right click, copy, going back to our main base window. I need to go into Tools and SQL Command, because this is updating the table, not just a query. I'm going to right-click, paste, and execute. We see command successfully executed. We can close this. Back in our relationships window, we should now be able to drag this over from our employee phone number table and make this a foreign key of our employee table. And we've got our one-to-many relationship. Right-clicking on the line, we're going to edit. And I believe we had update cascade and delete cascade for this relationship. I'll click OK. It worked. I'm going to save the relationship. And save the database.